There we are. We are live.
It's live.
It says live. I think we're live. 93.9 The Country Moose. You're here with me, Britt, from Britt's Morning Brew Crew, the new morning show that is here. And I've got Matt West with me. PBR, voice of the PBR, going to be here in Des Moines, Iowa, coming up this weekend. Matt, how the heck have you been? It's been for a while since I've seen you.
I've been good, but I'm nervous right now. You said this is the first time you went live with the Moose. I'm terrified. It's me because there's a really good chance I'm going to get you fired on this deal. I'm just happy to be part of the crew.
Like, yeah. I'm so happy to have you on here. Man, the brew crew, man.
it's crazy. Like, I love it. We've been friends for years and years and years. And, you know, it's always good to see friends. Especially with the craziness in the world right now, you know, the travel schedules and everybody's in different places in the world. So it's good to see you.
Yes. Yes. You too. Well, and you have been so busy. It's been so cool watching your stuff. I mean, you've got your Matt West podcast, mattwestnow.com, and you've got your podcast there, and you talk so much about all the things that you've been doing. Plus your social medias, you've been so crazy busy. Still going to the rodeos. The PBR has been awesome and still being on.
We've been so blessed. Our leadership team and our leadership there at the PBR, Sean Gleason, everybody, they've done a tremendous job in taking us to different places, but doing it safely. You know, they comprise this huge plan to get us back to work. And I don't care what anybody says in the world, the last professional sport going was the PBR and professional bull riders. The first professional sport back to work, back in front of fans, it's all been the PBR. And that's a little bit of a pat on the back to ourselves. And I think that's okay to be a little bit humbling, braggadocious, because now, you know, we've done it. We've done it safely. We've brought this sport back to the fans. Our leadership team has given us an opportunity to stay busy, keep working, and, you know, to do it with a plan in place that has, I think, fulfilled all of the safety guidelines and kept us all safe. So I'm excited. You know, even when we were having a couple of weeks off, it's a great time to stay busy. And whether that's staying busy with your family and your friends or trying new ventures, you know, working to launch new businesses, as long as you were doing something that made you happy, I think, you know, I think that's what it's all about.
Yeah, I am so with you on there. We have a couple viewers. We have some, if you can see down here, I don't know if you can see right underneath me here. Yeah, Ross from Charles City says hi. We've even got John from Nashville.
Well, that's a place I'd like to go someday.
I think I seem to remember something about Hermitage Cafe the one time we were there.
I used to frequent Nashville. I miss Nashville. You know, I just miss that scene. I miss just being around large groups of people that are super annoying and drunk, you know?
and the woo girls downtown, you know, all the bachelorettes going woo.
Yep, absolutely. I miss live music and all that stuff, but you know what? It's good. It's good. All is good.
Yeah. Well, and speaking of, so all the groups and stuff, this PBR here in Des Moines is going to be having spectators to there. Mm-hmm. Everybody needs to follow the protocol and everything. And if you look down, speaking of that below, if you go to 93.9kia.com, you have your chance to win tickets for this weekend. Tomorrow is the last day to possibly win those tickets. It's brought to you by 4C Western Store. It's right downtown Mason City. Great guys there, great gals there that can help you get outfitted out. They've got a 25% off any cowboy boots right now. So, and you know, Matt, cowboy boots are a staple.
Look, you gotta look the part. Actually, you don't have to look the part. It's a lot more fun when you do, okay?
Yes.
And it's funny because there's so many people that like, oh, you bought this jersey to go to one football game one time. Yeah, you bought these boots to go to one bull ride in one time. Absolutely. It's totally worth it. You know, do it. If that's what you want to do, do it. And obviously, it's a good place to do it. So my question is, can I win those tickets? Because
no.
I keep having friends ask for tickets everywhere we go. And, you know, it's a tough ticket to get with you know, the new guidelines and everything. So you better get them while you can.
Yeah, definitely. And I'm guessing that you guys have been sold out in most of the places you've gone since the new guidelines make it a little bit harder to have so many fans.
Yeah, I'm going to be completely honest with you right now. I have no idea. I don't know. So So, like, I used to ask questions about, you know, did we sell out? Are we close? How much? How close are we? You know, all those things. And then when we came back, especially in the second half, it's like it does not matter to me anymore. I don't care about the business side of it. I simply care that we're getting to work, that we're getting to be around our friends, that we're getting to bring the sport to the fans.
Yeah.
And that's the biggest thing. When the fans reach out on social media or things like this, where, you know, we can't talk and communicate like we used to. We can't all hang out in the different places like we used to, but we can continue to gather in these arenas and be in these buildings and enjoy this sport that's made so many of us friends anyways. And so I'm super thankful. I'm super blessed.
You have a friend.
Yeah, that's Burris. Burris okay. is one of our two dogs. And he's obviously a small little guy.
He's just a tiny little thing, like a Chihuahua. Is he a Chihuahua?
Yeah. I think he might have a little Chihuahua Doberman cross. He's actually lost weight. We took him to the vet the other day, and he's down to about 128 pounds.
Wow.
So, yeah.
Just a tiny thing.
Yeah. And the other one's just sitting here looking at us. So.
And speaking of, we have somebody else that's waving in here.
Oh, shocker. Shocker.
Is she in the other room?
Yeah, she's the one that let the dogs in here with me.
She's smart.
Just left,
so. We can't compete with dogs. I mean, there's dogs steal the show.
This is the other one, and she was down to about 120 pounds.
So she's just a tiny thing, too.
Yeah, on this awesome diet weight loss program. But no, it's good to be home at times.
Yeah.
See the kids.
Well, and speaking of little guys,
yeah.
I talked to Dalen Sorengen the other day.
He's
doing good. I mean, he's just so tiny. He's such a bull rider.
Yeah. You know what I love about Dalen is he's very much yes, ma'am, no, ma'am, yes, sir, no, sir. He's so polite. And for a kid that's had so much success at such a young age to be thrown in the spotlight the way he has, especially this year, you know, a kid that top five in a race for PBR world title. He's been to the national finals rodeo. He's been to the PBR finals. I mean, that kid, he's a stud.
Yeah.
And everything he's gone through in his career to be as humble and as kind and gracious. That's what I love about this sport. Mm-hmm. We've got some guys that are rock stars, but even the rock stars are very humble and very genuine, kind-hearted people.
Yeah.
You know, so you're a little rough around the edges.
So tell me a little bit about how the lineup looks like for Des Moines. Does it look good with the majority of the guys coming in?
Really good. And the cool thing about it is, you know, at a point in the season, there were some guys that were really banged up because of all the COVID scare. There were guys that got stuck in Brazil. We're back to a point where we've got the majority of the top 35 guys in the world here. And the couple of guys that have squeaked in as alternates are really cool stories, because if they do well this weekend, you know, they can solidify themselves a spot at the World Finals in Las Vegas. I look at Andrew Alvidrez this past weekend, who finished second in Billings, Montana, and I mean jumped up way up the world standings. Dakota Lewis in the past month and a half has went from like outside the top 60 to now he's knocking on the door of the World Finals. Like, those stories to me, to see those guys that, you know, this summer had no idea what was going to happen, to be able to take advantage of those opportunities. And, you know, they're in there with the best bull riders in the world because they deserve it and they belong there. And then you got guys like JB Mooney, like Jose Vitor Lemmy, Justin Lockwood came back last weekend, Joao Ricardo Vieira, Dalen, the guys that are in that world title race. I mean, the top five guys to me in the world are worth the ticket. Let me change that. The number one bull rider in the world is worth the price of admission. If you bought a ticket to come watch one guy get on one bull, it'd totally be worth it. This guy is so good. Just got his seventh event win. I mean, we're watching history, and we're watching a guy that could go down as the greatest of all time. I mean, he's certainly going to be in that conversation.
Oh, definitely. Well, I am so excited for it going on. If people didn't see it already, it's going to be this weekend, the 19th and 20th, the PBR, Unleash the Beast. And you know, the thing is that I think a lot of people are like, oh, it's just PBR. Well, there's a couple different tours going on though, too. Kind of explain a little bit on how that goes.
Well, how it works is the top 35 bull riders in the world are on our televised tour. It's what we call a Monster Energy Unleash the Beast. And that is our quote unquote major league tour. That's where, I mean, we call them the top 35 bull riders in the world because that's what they are. And so those are the folks, those are the guys that are going to be competing in Des Moines. We also have what's called the Velocity Tour, the Pendleton Whiskey Velocity Tour. So that's, you know, the rest of the field that are trying to climb their way up there, you know, 36 through 65, 70, you know, or so. Those are qualifying tours to get to the big leagues where we're going to be this weekend in Des Moines. There's also the Touring Pro Division, and those are typically just sanctioned events. But this is the tour that is actually produced by the organization for the best athletes in the world to put on the best show for the best fans in the world. And I truly believe that we do that. I think we have the best product in sports, not just Western sports. I think we've got the best product for our fans in all of sports.
That's awesome. I think it's just going to be an absolute blast. I think there's going to be so many people there. And speaking of a lot of these riders, you've talked to a lot of them on your podcast that you do.
Yeah. The cool thing about this podcast is it started off and I was going to use it as a platform to help showcase some of the guys like Dalen, some of the guys like Andrew Alvidrez. But it's turned into something that, you know, I can be selfish sometimes, and people that I'm a fan of, I want the rest of the world to understand why I'm a fan of them. And so we had some legends. I've had world champs like Adriano Moraes. I've had guys like Colby Yates that I've worked, you know, in the ride pass booth with. Had Jess Lockwood, Cody Webster, guys that are superstars. We're continuing to use those guys and just have fun with it. You know, podcast I'm getting ready to drop tomorrow is, look, if you're looking for something serious, it's not the place to go. the one I dropped earlier this week, you know, there's really inspirational stories. And I always say, there's so much positive in the world. Sometimes you just got to look for it. And that's what we try to do with the podcast. You know, it's called Matt West Now, but really it's not Matt West at all. It's about people that I'm a big fan of. And, you know, it doesn't matter what walk of life they come from, but we have a tendency to lean towards the PBR guys because, you know, I know them so well, and I'm such a big fan of them as people. Like Dalen, you know, they're good humans, and I want the rest of the world to see that. So, yeah, that's why we launched the podcast, and we're still having fun with it.
That's awesome. And where can people go find that?
Everywhere. It's on Spotify, SoundCloud. Those are the three main spots. But, again, you can go to mattwestnow.com, and you can log on. You can find everything. I post about it on social media all the time. But I promise you, it's fun. It's fun. Yeah.
So what's some of the fun things that you have looking forward to for the rest of the year then? I mean, I know we're getting closer and closer to October, but I think you have some other stuff going on too, I'm guessing.
The most exciting thing is wondering where we're going to go next. That's been kind of the hot topic of conversation all season long is, you know, with the current guidelines, what cities will welcome us in and what cities can we go to? That's what's made me such an even bigger fan about different places. So now Des Moines is going to have an even bigger special place in all of our hearts because city of Des Moines, you know, the state of Iowa has said, come on, we'll take you, because there's a lot of places in the world that aren't taking sports. So, of course we're excited about that. Unfortunately, and I don't know if I'm even supposed to say this, but we got the call today and we kind of knew it was coming, that Pensacola, we're supposed to be in Pensacola, Florida next weekend. Obviously, you know what? The event got canceled, and that's the least of our concerns right now, you know, because we're constantly thinking about and praying for those people in Pensacola, Florida. Will we make that event up? I don't know. You know, we're running out of time before the PBR World Finals and before we head to Las Vegas and crown a world champion. So it's going to be interesting, you know, but we're going to – crown a champion. Somebody's going to get $1 million. Somebody's going to get a Montana Silversmith buckle. Somebody's going to put their name down in the history book. And I'm just excited to be there as a fan and be along for the ride.
Oh, yeah. Well, and speaking of being a fan, now, a lot of times, I don't know if they're still doing this, but there is getting the fan pass ahead of time to come down, basically learning a little bit more about the PBR. And you're one of the tour guides on that usually. Is that still going on?
Yeah, sometimes it's a little different now, obviously, mm-hmm. because, you know, protocol. Once we get to a city or a venue we've tested, we're kind of inside a bubble now.
No, wait a second. You just said you're tested. And I think Dalen said that too. You guys get tested every show now, right?
Yeah, I think I've been tested 15 times, I think, something like that, 15 times total. You know, yeah, we get tested every week, especially now that we're going into different cities every weekend, just for a multitude of reasons. You know, obviously, we don't want to take the virus into a city. We don't want to leave a city with it and spread it amongst our team. You know, I believe the entire staff of the venue this weekend has been tested to go in there and go to work. Plus the pod seating, you know, they're selling tickets in groups, socially distancing. We're selling 50% of the, you know, the space available to us, which allows us to continue to do what I said at the beginning of this thing, you know, bring it to the fans safely. That's our number one priority right now. As much as anybody wants to get back to work and everybody wants to start doing what they normally do, we're doing it safely. And, you know, so yeah, we've been tested. We've been tested a bunch.
Yeah. So, okay. So after you get tested, then what do fans get to do?
The
fan tour, sorry.
Yeah. The great thing about it, the fans don't have to get tested.
No.
thankfully, you know, those VIP tours, they get up close and personal now with Flint Rasmussen, who is our, you know, our exclusive entertainer. PBR fans are going to know who he is. And every week there's a couple of bull riders like Dalen Swearingen, like Jess Lockwood, like Jose Vitor Lemmy, you know, some of these guys that'll come in and just sit down, spend a little bit of time talking with these fans, you know, explaining to them how everything's worked. This year has been a whole different conversation, but just the work that goes into this event before we ever pull into the city, to me, it's mind-boggling. We have the most amazing crew in the world that'll show up there a few days before anybody ever walks into the building. They have everything set up. They work diligently to try to make this a fun weekend for all of us to come in, enjoy it, do our jobs, and, you know, get to interact with fans. Fans will get to see things a little different. They'll get in before any other fans get in. You know, that whole VIP experience, it really is something special, because you get to see us rehearse and act like knuckleheads, and the things that aren't working, you get to see us mess up. If we mess up, you know, a rehearsal, you see that. If we change things in the span of the last 30 minutes before the show starts, you see that. So it's pretty
cool. And they get to ask questions, you know, if they have questions about the bulls, if they have questions about how it works, they get to kind of get those questions answered one-on-one.
Which, that's my favorite part of the entire thing. You know, that's the best part of my job, is being able to help educate people about the sport, because let's be honest, there's a lot of the world that still doesn't really know what goes on or how it happens or why it happens. And so we get to do that. We get to tell those stories. We get to educate a lot of people. And the coolest thing is, a lot of people will be like, hey, what's JB really like, you know, or hey, what's Jose really like? And we get to be honest and candid, and they get to see us not on a big screen, not behind a microphone, not, you know, if it's Flint, not in makeup. Yeah. You get to see the humans, and it's an anything goes type of atmosphere. You can ask anything.
Awesome. Which makes it definitely worth it.
So much fun. So much fun, you know, because I really feel like we're the most interactive sport in professional sports. Like, we love our fans, and we do our absolute best to show them. Look, if they're not coming, if they're not flipping over and watching on CBS Sports Network, if they're not, you know, commenting on social media, none of us get to live the lives we have. And so a lot of sports will say, oh, our fans are, you know, our fans are so important. No. Our fans are the lifeblood of every second that we get to enjoy this sport. And so, you know, for us to sit and get to chat and interact with them, that's the best part of this whole thing. It really genuinely is.
That's awesome. And speaking of, we have Tim is checking in from Wisconsin.
What's up, Tim?
Very awesome.
Tim, not too terribly far. Just head south.
Yeah, exactly. And a little bit west. Yes.
Good with whatever direction. Exactly. But
well, they had he's up a little bit more towards Milwaukee, Green Bay area. You guys had one in Green Bay not that long ago.
Yeah, we've been in Green Bay, you know, in the past few years. And I can say this, the miles I've put on this year, it's not far from Wisconsin to Des Moines. I don't care how far it is. We road tripped to Montana this past weekend.
Ooh.
It's been so much fun. Yeah, like we're getting to get out and see some of the world and go to Mount Rushmore and places like that. So if you're watching this and you're in, you know, I don't care if you're in Idaho or New York, whatever, get in the car. You got time to get there. Throw the family in and just enjoy some quality family time. It's totally worth it.
Exactly. Well, and again, if anybody wants to try and win some tickets right here down below, I think I'm pointing correctly. I'm a little bit backwards on my
I'm screen. Up and the down, but it's
in the down here. Yes. That you can have your chance to win tickets brought to you by 4C Western Store. You can also go and check out 4C Western Store. They have some deals going on during this time right before the rodeo. You get 25% off of boots. And I know that they've got all sorts of shirts in there. They've got the Wrangler shirts. They've got cinch. They've got all sorts of clothes in there, boots, hats, the whole works.
By the way, like, I think you should add to that. I think you should add another prize. They get to come hang out there in your living room because that place is amazing.
Thank you. Thank you.
Looks good.
Thank you. Yeah. Well, you know, I got a little bit of the Southwest motif and I'm always into fur. So, you know.
You look like you've been shopping at my girlfriend's boutique. I look like I'm at the barn, so it's fine.
Your girlfriend has an amazing boutique, by the way. I follow all of her Instagram stuff. By the way, she makes you look really, really good with her photos. What's
amazing is how good a photographer I am. That's the main thing.
I am impressed with that. I saw a couple gravel road photos the other day.
I get nothing other than told what to do. Where to stand and what lighting to get. Yeah.
So you're the Instagram boyfriend.
100%. I'm the trophy boyfriend right now. Somebody puts in the back room that when company comes over, they won't even see it. I'm that boyfriend.
Yeah. I see what she posted right here. Yeah.
There. In there somewhere.
Exactly. Tim says for some parking lot parties and some down home fun. Exactly. Look,
hey, I'm not going to come out there and stop you. I promise you. I promise you. Sunday afternoon, I might sneak out there and join you.
Yeah, definitely. Well, and it's going to be such a good time, and it looks like it's going to be great weather. Yeah. So everything's going to basically line up really well. So I appreciate you, Matt, coming on and joining me. I think we're going to go ahead and wrap it up. I know we've been talking for a while, but it's so good to see you.
Already? I just got here.
I know, right?
I'm here, and you're already kicking me out. No, that's okay. I really do. I appreciate it. It's really good to see you. I'm stoked for you. I'm happy for you. Appreciate you guys having us on. This is awesome.
Definitely. Well, I appreciate you coming on and can't wait to see you this weekend.
Des Moines. Can't wait.
Yeah.
Saturday, Sunday.